Friends, welcome to TYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics. And what we do, we daily cover your 2 subtopics, and in this manner in 6 days we cover all your 12 subtopics. So this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam, that is on 31st May. So your prelims is scheduled on 2nd June, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion, friends. And the first question is, in the demographic transition theory, a society that has achieved demographic maturity and high level of economic development is characterized by A. Low birth rates and high death rates, B. Low birth rates and low death rates, C. High birth rates and low death rates, D. High birth rates and high death rates. So here, friends, the answer would be B, that is low birth rates and low death rates. So when demographic transition takes place, then the level of demographic maturity is said to be achieved when there is low birth rate as well as low death rate. So the solution is B. Initially both the death rates and the birth rates are high, and then slowly the death rates death rate declines, but the birth rate remains high, and in later stage birth rate also starts declining and death rate also is low. So that stage is called mature stage of demographic transition. So the solution is B. So here is the explanation. So you can see, as I have told you, that that the demographic transition theory can be used to predict the future population of any area. So in this way this works. So currently India, what India is facing is currently India has from last 2 decades has witnessed the population explosion, but now it is moving towards mature phase of demographic transition. So in this way this demographic transition works. Let's move on to the second question. The second question is, consider the following statements about literacy in India. First, a formal education or minimum educational standard is necessary to be considered as literate in India. And second is, literacy of an individual must be tested in the official language of India. So we have to choose that which of the above is correct. So let me tell you, friends, that none of these is correct, because there is no such thing that there is a minimum educational standard. Simply a person who can read and not even he's able to write, he is also considered literate. So on the basis of it, his reading abilities only. So, and there is no such thing that literacy can be tested in a particular official language. So in any language, if a person can write, or for that matter read, he is considered literate. So none of these is correct. So the answer would be D. Solution is D. So there is no explanation to this question. And if in case you want to get the explanations of all the questions, then you have to contact to us on our email ID, that is achieveyes21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So you can also contact us. And obviously, certainly there will be a minimum certain cost that will be associated with the explanation PDFs, but it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the term denotified tribes refers to communities A, which are de-recognized by the government of India, B, which have been recently included in scheduled caste category, C, which were notified as criminal tribes during colonial rule, D, which are not mentioned in the constitution. So we have to choose the correct answer. And let me tell you, friends, that denotified tribes are those tribes which were described as criminal tribes during the colonial rule. So the solution is C. So during the colonial rule, these tribes faced immense discrimination and exclusion, and now also exclusion is at high exclusion is high, but certainly the conditions have improved after independence. Fourth question is the Silk Road Economic Belt and the Maritime Silk Road are parts of A. North-South Transport Corridor, B. One Belt, One Road Initiative, C. India-Myanmar Thailand Trilateral Highway, D. Kaladan Multimodal Project. So we have to choose the correct answer. And let me tell you friends that Silk Road Economic Belt and Maritime Silk Road are parts of One Road One Belt Initiative that China is undertaking. So it is basically the 21st century diplomacy of China to revive traditional routes, maritime and the silk routes. And now it is expanding its connectivity and its trade relations, and also it is setting up its strategic assets all over the world. So it is a kind of a very assertive policy that is followed by China. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is, what is often referred to as demographic trap is actually? First, sub-replacement level fertility rates. Second, under utilization of present demographic dividend. So we have to choose that which of the above is correct. And let me tell you friends that none of these is correct. Demographic trap is actually a high birth rate but low death rate. So none of these is the answer. So D would be the answer. Solution is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, which of these necessarily implies that the total fertility rate of a country is increasing? A. Population of the country is growing. B. Population is aging. See, death rates have declined considerably in the past. D, none of the above. So friends, here also the answer would be none of the above, because in case if the population is growing, it certainly it is not necessary that it is only due to increase in fertility rate. It might be possible that immigration is taking place in the region, and population is aging, and that has no relation with the total fertility, because population may be increasing due to the population is aging. And it is there because of the availability of better health services that the population is aging. So C is certainly not the part. So the answer is D, that is none of the above. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about Podu cultivation system. First, it is a system of shifting cultivation followed in Odisha by some tribal communities. Second, it is generally practiced in hills since it reduces the chances of crop damage due to accumulation of water at one place. So we have to choose the correct answer, and let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So it is basically practiced in Odisha. In fact, in India, largest area under shifting cultivation is in Odisha. So this is also a type of shifting cultivation. So it is generally practiced in hills because the plain lands are controlled by the affluent people, and also in valley areas there is accumulation of water at one place which causes the crop damage. So certainly it is limited to hills. So the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the Panama Canal has significantly shortened the distance between which two port cities? A. New York and San Francisco, B. Tacoma and Los Angeles, C. Ireland and Caribbean, D. Florida and Washington. So we have to choose the correct answer, and let me tell you friends that basically this has reduced the distance between the New York, that is in the east part of the USA, and San Francisco, that is towards the west of USA country. So it has reduced the distance between the two. So the answer is A. The resolution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the census of India differentiates between urban and rural areas on which of the following criteria? First, occupational structure. Second, literacy rates. Third, resource base. Fourth, population size. So we have to choose the correct answer, and let me tell you friends that the answer is 1 and 4, because this occupational structure and population size has this altered your area. And it is used for the purpose of differentiating urban and rural areas. So occupational structure, for example, 75% of the males, if they are engaged in non-agriculture activities, and if a particular area has more than 5,000 population, then it is considered urban. So answer would be 1 and 4 only. So the solution is A. Let's move on to the last question of the day. Last question is the 10th question. The largest amount of land in India is devoted to which of the following category of land uses? A. Culturable wasteland, B. Net zone area, C. Current fallow, D. Social forestry. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B, that is net zone area. So it is quite high in India. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then please do hit a like and also ensure that you share it with your friends and also subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications about the updates that we do on our channel. And lastly, friends, if you want to want the detailed PDFs of these MCQs that we cover daily on daily basis, then you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is our contact number. So in this way you can also contact us. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Thank you, have a very nice day.